Hey guys, welcome back to CMA Junction. So today we are going to see discounted cash flow techniques. In the previous video, we have seen non-discounted cash flow techniques. Now what is discounted cash flow technique? Discounted cash flow technique is a technique in which we will consider time value of money. Now first we'll see discounted payback period. Discounted payback period method is similar to that of payback period method we have seen in non-discounted cash flow techniques. Payback period method consider the time period in which initial investment is recovered, similar to that is discounted payback period method. In this, we'll find out the period in which we'll recover the initial investment while considering the time value of money. So to know this method, we have to take one example. For that, we have years and their cash flow after tax. Now we need to consider the time value of money, and for that we need to find present value factor. So first we'll find out present value factor considering the percentage at 10%. Now we'll calculate present value factor at 10%. Now how to calculate these? We need to take 1 divided by 1 point, add the percentage. Here 10%, then it is equal to 0.10. Then 1.10 will be added here. So what we need to do is 1 divided by 1.1 is equal to 0.909. Similarly, this is for first year. For next year, you need to press equal, then you will get for next year. And similarly, you can press equal and get for the further years. Now, if we need to calculate for 20%, then 1 divided by 1.20 we need to take, and that is equal to 0.833, next 0.694. Now, for our current question, we need to take 1 divided by 1.1, that is equal to 0.909 for the first year. For second year, we will take equal, then it is equal to 0.826. For next year, 0.751, and further 0.683, next is 0.621, and last is 0.564. I hope you understand how to calculate PVF, that is present value factor. Now from this we will calculate PV. Now how to calculate PV? For calculating present value, we need to take cash flow after tax and present value factor. We need to multiply both of this to calculate present value. Now, 20 lakh into 0.909, that is equal to 18.18 lakhs. 25 lakh into 0.826, that is equal to 20.65 lakhs. Next, 30 lakh into 0.751, that is equal to 22.53 lakh. Next is 30 lakh into 0.683, that is equal to 20.49 lakh. Similarly, you can calculate both of this, 12.42 lakh and 16.92 lakh. Now we will find out cumulative present value. Cumulative present value can be find out with considering the total of all previous values, previous present values. So first 18.18 lakh, second is 18.18 lakh plus 20.65 lakh, that is equal to 38.83 lakh. Next is 18.18 lakh, 20.65 lakh and 22.53 lakh, that is equal to 61.36 lakh. And similarly, you can calculate for 4th, 5th and 6th year, 18.85 lakh. 94.27, 111.19 lakh. Now, if you see this cumulative previous present values, then we'll know that we have initial investment of 100 lakh first of all. So, for payback period, we need to find that when this initial investment is recovered. So, it will be recovered between 5th or 6th year. Because in the 5th year, we'll earn 94.27 lakh and 6th year, we'll earn 119.19 lakh, which is more than that of 100 lakh. So, initial investment will be recovered between 5th and 6th year. So, how to calculate the period in which we'll recover. So for that, we need to consider first of all 5 years, total 5 years in cash flow will be considered, plus for 6th year, we need to take only the amount of inflow which is necessary to complete the 100 lakhs. So we have 100 lakh we need to complete. We have completed 94.27 lakh till 5th year. So in the 6th year, we need to get the 100 minus 94.27 lakh. In 6th year, we have cash inflow of 30 lakh. Sorry, we will consider the present value of cash inflow, that is equal to 16.92 lakh. Now we'll solve it. 5 years plus 100 minus 94.27 is equal to 5.73 divided by 16.92, that is equal to 5.3534 years. I hope you get what I want to tell you. So this is the way to calculate discounted payback period. We have calculated as that of payback period. Only the change is that here we have considered present value factor and we have taken present values to calculate the discounted payback period. So the minimum discounted payback period is preferred as that of payback period. Payback period is also preferable when it is minimum. So next we'll see net present value method. Now what is this net present value method? Net present value method considers the net present value which we have already calculated here. Now if we total this value, it will be known as net present value. 111.19 lakh is the total and it will be known as net present value. I hope you understand what is the net present value. Now for this also we'll take one example so that it will be much more clear. Now next we are going to see net present value method. Net present value is calculated while taking present value of cash inflows minus present value of cash outflows. So present value of cash inflow is already calculated in this example. This is present value of cash inflows and we have present value of cash outflows which is equal to 100 lakh. By deducting 111.19 lakh with 100 lakh, we'll get 11.19 lakh, which is the net present value. So to calculate this, to have more clarity about net present value, we'll take one example. See, Z Limited has two projects under consideration, A and B. We have two projects and the cost of both the projects are 60 lakhs. The project are mutually exclusive. Life of project A is 4 years and for B is 3 years. Salvage value we have nil for both the projects and tax rate is given 33.99 lakh. Cost of capital is 15%. Cash inflow is already given for 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th year. For project A it is 60, 110, 120 and 50. For project B it is 100, 130 and 50. And PV factor, that is the present value factor, we need not calculate it. It has already been given to us. Now we'll start this example. In this we have to find out which project is much more preferable. So let's start this question. We have rupees in lakhs. Now 4 year has been given for project A. Project A cash inflows are given for 4 years. 60 lakh, 110 lakh, 120 lakh and 50 lakh. Then we have as cash inflows are given and also the life of the project is also given. Then we need to consider the depreciation also. We need to consider that these cash inflows are profit before depreciation and tax. So we need to deduct depreciation and as tax rate are also given, then we need to deduct the tax rates tax also. So first we'll deduct here depreciation. Depreciation is for projects A and B, we have cost that is 60 lakh, cost of project is 60 lakh, then depreciation will be calculated in this 60 lakh. For project A, we have life of the project as 4 years. Now the depreciation is calculated as cost of the project divided by life of the project, that is equal to 60 divided by 4, that is equal to 15 lakhs. 15 lakhs will be the depreciation, similar for all the years, that is 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, it will be same 15 lakhs. Now for project B, 60 lakhs divided by 3, that is equal to 20 lakhs per annum depreciation will be charged. Now depreciation for project A, that is equal to 15 lakh, 15 lakh will be charged for all the years. Now after deducting this depreciation, we'll get profit before tax, that is equal to 45, 95, 105 and 35. Now we'll deduct the tax at the rate 33.99%, that is equal to 15.3. 95 multiplied by 33.99%, that is equal to 32.29. Next it is 35.70 and last is 11.90. After deducting the tax, we'll get profit after tax, that is equal to 29.70, 62.71, 69.30 and last is 23.10. Now after getting profit after tax, we'll add profit after tax with depreciation, that is equal to 15 each. Now after adding depreciation, we'll get net cash inflow. Now net cash inflow is equal to 44.70, 77.71, 84.30 and 38.10. Now we have discounting factors. We'll consider them. See, we have calculated net cash inflow after tax, then we'll consider the PVF, that is present value factor or discounting factor. It has been given for this question at 15%, that is equal to 0.870 for first year, second year it is 0.756, for third year it is 0.685, for fourth year it is 0.572. Now we can calculate the PV, that is equal to cash inflow after tax multiplied by PVF factors. So net cash inflow multiplied by discounting factor, that is equal to 38.89 lakhs, 58.75 lakhs, 57.75 lakhs and 21.79 lakhs. These are the present values of net cash inflow. Now we can calculate the total net cash inflow. Total can be calculated by adding all the net cash inflows for first, second, third and fourth years. That is equal to 117.18. By adding this, now we get the total net cash inflow. Now we need to calculate the total net cash outflow that is given in our question, that is equal to 60 lakh. Total net cash outflow, that is equal to 60 lakhs. After deducting this, we will get the net present value. Net present value is 117.18 lakhs for project A. Now similar to this, we can calculate for project B also. So you can see here we have calculated project B also. Cash inflow 100, 130 and 50. We have deducted first depreciation, that is equal to 20 lakhs. Then we got PBT, that is equal to profit before tax. Then after deducting tax, we get profit after tax. Then after adding depreciation, we'll get net cash inflow, and by multiplying net cash inflow with discounting factor, we get PV of net cash inflows. Now after totaling the net cash inflows, PV of net cash inflow, we have deducted it with net cash outflow, that is equal to 60. Then we got the net present value, that is equal to 100.621. Now we can compare the net present value of project A and project B. For project A, it is 117.18. For project B, it is 100.621. As the net present value of project A is higher, we'll consider the project A for implementation. I hope this question is clear with you, and with this we have completed the net present value also. From this we get to know also that higher the NPV, more it is preferable. Now next is profitability index or desirability factor or benefit cost ratio. Now what is this? Profitability index represent present value of benefit for each rupee of cash outlay. If we have given our 1 rupee, then in return what we get is known from profitability index. If profitability index is more than 1, project is acceptable. If it is equal to 0, project may or may not be acceptable, but it is, if it is less than 1, then it is not acceptable. So we need to know this. Next, when NPV is more than 0, this is important. When NPV is more than 0, then PI will always be greater than 1. We need to know this, as we consider same formulas for NPV and PI. We calculate PV of cash inflow in NPV also and PV of cash outflow in NPV. So both of this we need to take from the NPV table only and divide them to get profitability index. So from this project B we can calculate PI, that is profitability index. For profitability index we need to consider profit value, present value of net cash inflows, that is equal to 160.621 divided by present value of net cash outflow, that is equal to 60. So after dividing this we can calculate it, and it is equal to 2.677. so in this way we can calculate profitability index. Now what is internal rate of return? Next topic is internal rate of return. Internal rate of return is the discount rate at which sum of discounted cash inflows is equal to sum of discounted cash outflows. Now we need to make the net cash inflows and net cash outflows equal considering a rate which will be known as internal rate of return. At this point, that is at IRR, net present value will be zero always. Now IRR is the reinvestment rate at which cash flows are reinvested. We calculate the IRR, which is an in reinvestment rate which help us to know if we invest our cash inflows, then what is the rate we'll get from. So for this, if IRR is more than cost of capital, cost of capital is the normal rate which we consider for calculating PV factors. Now if IRR is more than cost of capital, then project is acceptable. If IRR is less than cost of capital, of course that project is not acceptable. If IRR is equal to cost of capital, then project may or may not be acceptable. So for this, let's take one example. Example, project cost is 1,10,000, cash inflows are given year 1, year 2, year 3 and year 4. 60,000, 20,000, 10,000 and 50,000, aapko calculate karna hai IRR. We need to calculate IRR. So, let's start this question. First of all, we need to calculate a payback period. Payback period. So how to calculate this payback period? We need to take the initial investments. Divided by average cash flows, cash inflows per annum. Now initial investment we have 1,10,000. And after calculating average cash flows, how to calculate average cash flow per annum? 60,000 plus 20,000 plus 10,000 plus 50,000 divided by 4. That is equal to 35,000. We got 3.14 as the payback period. Now considering this, we'll calculate the discount rate. So for 4 years, we have the 10% as the total for 4 years. 10% discounting factor is the approximate value for 3.14 in 4 years. So why we considered it for 4 years? Because 4 years information has been given to us. So 3.14, we can calculate it 1 divided by 1.10, that is equal to 0.909. For next year, it is equal to 0.826. For further, 0.7513. And next, it is 0.680. Now, 6830. That is equal to 3.1693. That is approximately equal to 3.14. So we can consider this that we can get 3.14 at 10% in 4 years. So we'll consider the 10% as the discount rate and we'll calculate IRR. For that, we need to first calculate the NPV. So we have year and cash inflows. Year cash inflows. We have 4 years information. 60,000, 20,000, 10,000 and 50,000. We have 10% as the discounting factor. Now from this we will calculate present value factor at the rate 10%. That is equal to 0.909. 0.826, 0.751 and 0.683. Now we'll calculate present values, that is equal to 60,000 into 0.909, that is 54,540, 16,520, 7,510 and 34,150. Now the total of this present value is 112,720. Present value of inflows. Now after deducting this with present value of outflows, outflows is 110,000. We get the NPV, that is equal to 2720. Now as we got the NPV as positive, now we need to consider one more discounting rate from which we'll get this NPV as negative. So for that we need to go further. As at the rate 12%. For example, we'll take first at the rate 12%. And for that, we'll calculate present value. So at the rate 12%, present value factor is 0.893, 0.797, 0.712 and 0.636. Now we'll calculate present value for this. 60,000 multiplied by 0.893, that is equal to 53,580. 20,000 multiplied by 0.797 is equal to 15,940. 10,000 multiplied by 0.712, that is equal to 7,120. And last is 50,000 multiplied by 6.636, that is equal to 31,800. Total present value is 1,08,440. And present value of outflow, that is equal to 1,10,000. After deducting this, we get minus 1560. So one we need to get at positive and one we need to get at negative. So if we get NPV as positive, then we need to go further for discounting rate and we'll get the negative number. If we get the NPV as negative, then we need to go for previous numbers. If we have 10% and we got NPV as negative, in that case we need to go for 8% or 6% so that we can get the negative positive also. This we have done to calculate IRR. Now IRR can be calculated using two methods. One is forward, second is backward. First we'll solve it with forward method. I personally consider the forward method first. Forward method means taking the positive NPV. So we'll consider this positive NPV. Positive NPV is at 10%. At 10% we have positive NPV. So how to calculate this? IRR will be calculated while considering the positive percentage plus NPV at 10%. So positive percentage and NPV at positive percentage, that is equal to 2720 divided by difference between the NPVs. So 2720 minus 1560 is equal to 4280. Multiplied by difference in rate. How much is the difference? 10% and 12% difference is 2%. Now if we calculate this, we will get 10% plus 1.27%, that is equal to 11.27%. Now what is the backward method? In the backward method, we consider the discounting rate of negative value. Now what is the negative value? 1560, and then discounting rate is 12%. Now how to calculate this? This can be calculated as IRR considering the negative discounting factor minus NPV at 12% and total difference multiplied by difference in rate. So 12%, NPV at 12% is minus 1560, total difference is same 4280, and difference in rate is same 2%. Now considering this, we get 11.27. So answer will be same in both the methods, forward or backward. I hope you understand how to calculate this discounted cash flow techniques. So with this, we'll end our today's video. I hope you understand all the things which I had told you. If you like the video, please do press the like button and subscribe our channel to get more updates. So that's it. See you all in the next video.